In this titration lab, we are going to start by gathering our necessary materials. We have some vinegar, which is going to be what we are trying to find the amount of acid in. We have our standard, which is sodium hydroxide, and we have our indicator, which is phenolphthalein. Please make note of the concentration of the sodium hydroxide, 0.1113 moles per liter. We're also going to use a burette and a 5 milliliter pipette. We also need a suction bulb to draw up the liquid for the pipette. You're going to see on your lab sheet, there is an experimental data table where you will be recording some of your data. First, what we want to do is we want to rinse the burette with some deionized water. We want to swirl that around, give that a quick clean, empty some of that into the sink. And then what we want to do is we want to repeat that process with some of our standard, some of that 0.1113 moles per liter sodium hydroxide. We're going to open the stopcock to allow some of the air to run out, and we're going to record the initial volume. Then what we're going to do is we're going to rinse the pipette. We're going to draw up some of that water. We're going to rinse that out. And then we're going to repeat that process with some of the vinegar. We're going to draw up exactly 5 milliliters of vinegar, and we're going to transfer that into our Erlenmeyer flask. We're going to also add a little bit of water to that flask and 5 drops of phenolphthalein. In this lab, we're trying to determine the concentration of acid in vinegar. We're going to titrate until we obtain a endpoint of a faint pink color. At that point, we have all the moles of acid being neutralized by the moles of base. This is called the equivalence point. We don't want to overshoot the equivalence point. If we go too far, then the solution will be too pink, and that means we've added more base and we've passed that mole equivalent ratio. So now I've titrated to a pink color, and I'm going to indicate in my chart the final volume. After about a minute, you notice that the pink color has dissipated a little bit to a faint pink, and that's what we want. Trial 2, please record the initial volume of base needed and the final volume that was obtained, and trial 3, and the final volume obtained.